In this video, we're going to go through the process of preparing and operating the Infinity processor. The Infinity processor is a benchtop machine that allows daily washout of progeny, feeding, and recording videos of animal movement. There are five basic steps to run your experiments with the Infinity processor: setup, calibration, experiment prep, washing, imaging, and feeding, and sterilization. We'll start, of course, by pressing the power button located on the side. The button will light up and the internal LEDs will light as well. The touchscreen display will open to the main menu. Check to make sure that the inlet and the outlet tubes are connected to each other by a connector tube in each slot of the unit. Be sure that you have your five 50-milliliter conical tubes for food, media or NGM buffer, 70% ethanol, DI water, and waste. You'll need a 50-milliliter measuring cylinder as well. If you're processing multiple Infinity chips, it's convenient to use the 250-milliliter bottles included with the unit. Use one for waste and one for NGM buffer. Also, make sure that the Filmic Pro app is set up and ready on the iPod. Okay, your setup is now complete. The next step is to calibrate the pumps to verify that the washing and the feeding flow rates are correct. On the main menu, press Calibration. Connect lines L1 and L2 to the DI water. Drop your waistline into the 50-milliliter measuring cylinder. This is how you're going to measure the pump output. Choose the pump connected to L1 to calibrate first. The pump will run for 60 seconds. After 60 seconds, check to see that between 15 and 16 milliliters has been collected. If the volume is correct, press Done. If the volume is not within that range, then press Calibrate. Here you can adjust the flow rate up and down by adjusting the voltage to the pump. If it's pumped less than 15 milliliters, press the Up button. If it's pumped more than 16 milliliters, press the Down button. Note that a 1 milliliter change in volume will require a change of 0.1 to 0.2 volts. Press Continue and the pump will cycle again for 60 seconds. Repeat this process until the pump output is between 15 and 16 milliliters and press Done. Next, from the main menu, select Calibration again and repeat the process for L2. Once both pumps are calibrated, you're ready to move on to the next step, which is experiment prep. In the experiment preparation step, you'll sterilize the lines and fill them with media and food. Back on the main menu, press the Experiment Prep button. Follow the instructions to connect the L1 and L2 lines to the ethanol reservoir. Press Start. This will start the ethanol pumping through the lines for 20 seconds to sterilize them. Next is step 2 of 3. Connect L1 and L2 to the NGM buffer and then press Start on the touchscreen. This will pump the NGM buffer through the system and flush out any remaining ethanol. Once this is complete, move on to step 3 of 3. Connect L2 to the food reservoir, and then press Start. The pump will cycle for 10 seconds. And as a quick note, if you're adding food or a drug manually into the Infinity chip, just leave L1 and L2 connected to the media when you run step 3 of 3. The Infinity processor preparation is now complete, and you're ready to insert the Infinity chips for washing and feeding. Place the animal-loaded chips into the device slots. Either direction is fine. Use a piece of Scotch tape to clean any fiber or debris off of the top of the chip, kind of like a tiny lint roller. Disconnect the connector tube and connect the inlet and outlet tubes to the ports on either end of the chip. Be sure you keep the connector tubes in a safe spot. You're going to need those when the processor isn't being used. If they aren't already, turn your iPods on and open the Filmic Pro app. Choose the Infinity preset that you've already created and place the imaging station itself on the main unit, making sure that it fits into the slotted groove snugly. Your iPods should now be displaying the animals in the chip. There are a few settings that you might need to adjust in Filmic Pro at this point to get the best image possible. Set your exposure so the image is clear and visible. And set your gain down to the lowest setting so you don't get any visual noise in your movies. You can also zoom in just a bit if you like. Just be sure that these four dots on the chip are still in the frame. Now, go ahead and press the record button on the Filmic Pro app on the iPods. This will begin recording the washing process. Once this is done, go back to the main menu and press Wash Feed. Here we'll choose the default wash time of 90 seconds. If you watch quickly, you can see the washing process sweep out any progeny. Once the 90-second wash cycle is done, stop recording your movie on the iPods to keep your washing videos separate. Now you're ready to video record animal movement. Press the record button on the Filmic Pro app and record a movie for 90 seconds. You can process these movies with the Infinity Code software to obtain animal survival curves and locomotor reactivity. And as a side note, if this is a drug screen, after the progeny washing, food with drugs can be added manually into the chip using a pipette with gel loading tips. If you do this, make sure that lines L1 and L2 remain connected to the media bottle during the experiment prep step. However, if the animals in all the chips are being fed with the same food, feeding can be done with the processor by pressing the Begin Feeding button on the touchscreen. The default feeding process is very short, only 2 seconds. But be assured, the animals are getting the proper amount of food. The touchscreen will now read Feeding Completed. If you'd like to, you can record additional videos after feeding using the imaging station in the Filmic Pro app. Once washing, imaging, and feeding is complete, remove the imaging station and disconnect the chips. Next, put the chips in a petri dish and make sure to add about 10 milliliters of DI water on the sides to maintain a humidified environment. And do not forget to add water to the petri dish once every 3 to 4 days to prevent them from drying out. Okay, your chips are ready to be stored in your incubator. If you have more chips to process, simply connect the new chips and follow the same process, starting from the washing step, and store them in the incubator. Next, you'll need to complete the sterilization process. Go back to the main menu and choose Sterilization. If you haven't already, remove the chips and reconnect the inlet and outlet tubes. Then connect L1 and L2 to the ethanol reservoir. Press Start and the pumps will cycle for 20 seconds. Washing the tubes completely with 70% ethanol. Step 2 of 2 is to rinse out the ethanol with DI water. Connect L1 and L2 to the DI water and then press Start. Once this process is complete, you can go ahead and turn off the Infinity processor. And don't leave the tubing in the media bottle overnight. Instead, put the tubing in the ethanol reservoir. This helps to keep the line sterile. And here are a few tips and important things that you'll want to remember. When the Infinity processor has not been used for a while, there might be some air in the lines, so we recommend running the calibration twice before adjusting the pump flow rate. If you are conducting a multi-day experiment with the same Infinity chip, you'll want to switch the direction of the chips in the Infinity processor each day. This helps to prevent any possibility of the progeny clogging an outlet. An easy way to remember which side is which is to put a small piece of tape on either end of the chip and mark them with a plus and a minus sign. This will help you keep track of which side you have on top each day. To conserve usage of buffers during lifespan experiments, you can reduce the wash time to 10 seconds after animal reproduction ends. For consistency, make all the NGM buffer bottles together at one time for your experiment. For larger scale experiments, use the 250-milliliter bottles. Feeding can be done offline when different reagents or chemicals are being tested. Alternatively, it is convenient to use the Infinity processor when the same food is added to all the chips. And last but not least, a pair of Infinity chips is exposed to lab temperatures and light for about 3 to 5 minutes during processing. So, to minimize variability in your experiment, store them in humidified petri dishes in the incubator immediately.